antigen specific T cell mediated autoimmune disease, such a kind of EAD. So, in summary, immune system and non-immune system interact with each other, at least in part, through IL-6 amplifier. And this IL-6 amplifier dependent on NF-kappa B activation and STAT3 activation. And furthermore, in our F759 mutant mouse, this STAT3 activation was enhanced in non-immune system. I'd like to remind you, this mutation requires not on T cells, but in non-immune cells, further outside development. Okay? Anyway, this mutation induces enhanced STAT3 activation non-immune cells, for example, type 1 collagen positive cells. And furthermore, so this enhanced STAT3 results in the dysregulation of IL-6 amplifier, because in this case, break is defective. Stop signal is defective because tyrosine 759 is a critical tyrosine residue which is required for the SOC3 over SHP2 mediated negative feedback. So this mutation induces dysregulation of IL-6 amplifier. Then resulting the F759 outlier. Still we don't know the actual why that's why, okay, it's a very bad. Anyway, and furthermore, HTLV1P40 tax gene, which activates NF-kappa B, results in the enhanced arthritis. So, furthermore, as I mentioned, MOGTH17 T cell mediated, this is, in this case, EAD, so this is a tissue specific autoimmune disease. Even in this case, IL-6 amplifier seems to be playing a role even in tissue-specific autoimmune disease. So, EAE, wake up. So, correctly, I am thinking that any event, for example, tissue-specific T cell, or virus infection, or bacterial infection, or even injury, or even physical stimulation in the local region, which can activate either NF-kappa B or STAT3 or both in a given tissue. We don't care what is the initial trigger. Maybe it depends, it's different on the disease. Maybe it's a patient, maybe it's a different. Anyway, any event which can affect either NF-kappa B or STAT3, at least, triggers autoimmune disease or chronic inflammatory progressive disease through, at least in part, dysregulation of IL-6 amplifier. Because once IL-6 is induced, then a lot of cytokines, including chemokine, other agent molecule, set many genes are activated. So this loop may play important. So anyway, I have discovered one of the essential factors involved in immune system IL-6. It's the multifunctional cytokine involved in not only immune system, but also in inflammation, hematopoiesis, nervous system, and even in early development of our body. So, we found the presence of a large amount of IL-6 in synovial fluid of rheumatoid arthritis, suggesting IL-6 plays a role in rheumatoid arthritis. In fact, this regulation of IL-6 signaling pathway, as I mentioned, spontaneously induced autoimmune arthritis in mice, that is F759 arthritis. This is very much like human rheumatoid arthritis. Furthermore, I found the presence of IL-6 amplifiers, which connect the non-immune cells and the immune system, and at least in part play a critical role in F759 arthritis. And so, the fact led me to speculate that any event, any reagent, any password. I don't care. Anyway, capable of chronically activating either or both encephalitis statin or other strategy factor induced rheumatoid arthritis. And this scenario may be applied in other autoimmune diseases in general. So, finally, as told by Professor Kishimoto, anti-acid-receptor antibody treatment which inhibits action has been found to be beneficial for patients. So, just a basic studies during the last 30 years very much contributes toward understanding the immunological mechanism of rheumatoid arthritis and paves the way to develop new drugs beneficial for patients with rheumatoid arthritis. And hopefully, other autoimmune disease and inflammatory disease. So, finally, I'd like to acknowledge many people, in particular, late Professor Yuichi Yamamura, and late Professor Kaoru Onoue, and Professor Sohei Kondo, and in particular, the Professor Tadamitsu Kishimoto. All of them are my great mentors. And also, I'd like to thank Professor Kiyoshi Takatsu, Professor Tadatsugu Taniguchi, and Professor Takeshi Watanabe for their very continuous suggestion, support, and encouragement. And also, I'd like to acknowledge my many friends and colleagues, Tetsuya Taga, Kiyoshi Yasukawa, Dr. Katsuhiko Yamasaki, Tsuyoshi Terabishi, Shizu Akira, and Hitoshi Kikutani, Kazuyuki Yoshizaki, and Yoichiro Iwakura. And finally, I'd like to acknowledge my very close colleagues, in particular, the Koichi Nakajima, Tadashi Matsuda, Katsuhiko Ishihara, Masahiko Hibi, and Masaaki Murakami, and many other colleagues. And finally, since I met first Professor Kishimoto in 1973, this is taken one day, in Baltimore, we have come so far. We have done so much. But there is so much more to do. So finally, I'm very much grateful to the Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences and the Crawford Foundation. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you.